Rahul Deora. He's from Find and he's going to show us an exciting demo.
Hey guys, my name is Rahul. So I see that all the conversation is about text and voice. Images and videos are getting no love, so I'm here to change that. So visual AI is improving at an astounding rate. Just at the start of 2022, we had the first version of Midjourney come out. And as you can see, like, it generates what you want, but kind of in a cartoonish way. Just 1.5 years later, you had Midjourney V6, which would almost generate photorealistic images. And this is just in a span of 1.5 to 2 years. So you can see the rate at which things are going. I'm sure all of you people have seen AI-generated images on your feeds, on Instagram or Twitter. The images can be very creative. They can be inspiring. They can be astounding, actually. And I'd say that about 10% of AI-generated images currently cannot be distinguished as being fake. And that number is only going to increase in the next 6 months to 1 year. But what about India? So India is a very diverse land, one of the most diverse countries in the world. We have more than 3,500 different monuments. We have more than 1,000 different languages. We have more than 1,000 different types of food. And we have over 2,000 different types of personalities. So it's very difficult to capture so much diversity through unstructured pre-training. Many of these large vision models which are made abroad or in Europe or in the US, they don't capture all the nuances of Indian culture. So we decided to start a project called Bharat Diffusion. We want to make a large vision model which can generate very realistic images for India, which knows about Indian culture, which knows about Indian concepts. So we trained our first POC model. For this model, we collected around 2 lakh images, which is only about 0.2 million images. And as you can see, there are some results here. We were actually quite surprised by the quality which we achieved. In fact, even in the previous slide I showed you, all of these images are generated by the first version of our model. Thank you. So let's do something fun. Let's try a demo. Okay. So, can you guys name a monument which you would like us to generate? Red Fort? Okay, let's try Red Fort. Let's see. Okay, now why don't you guys name a famous personality? Shahrukh Khan, okay, let's try Shahrukh Khan. Sure, let's try a photo for farmer next. Yeah, just make the prompt a bit creative, maybe. Farmer in Rajasthan. Forgot to mention Indian. Okay, this is a bit Indian. Okay. Okay, can we switch back to the presentation? So this was the first version of our model. Since then, we were quite happy with our initial model. So we decided to go way bigger. So as I said that, we just collected around 0.2 million images for our first model. Till now, we've collected more than 5 million images, which is around 50 lakh images. And we made sure to cover a lot of diverse concepts. So we actually like go through a lot of Indian concepts manually and then collect images. Creating the prompts is also a tricky business. You have to actually structure your prompts really well so that the, you know, when the user types something descriptive, the model is able to understand and generate that. So there's work on not only the image part, but also getting the right captions in place. So I'm going to show you a sneak peek. We're just talking about images right now, but here's what the future is going to look like. So this is, I'm going to show you like a video of a model, some video which is generated by OpenAI's model called Sora. They recently released this, the model is not out yet, but they've put out some demo videos. So basically you can type in a small prompt and the model will generate around like a 30 to 45 second video. And they are super realistic. And kind of got some clips here for you to show the diversity and the realism of what can be captured. Okay, there's some technical problems, so the video isn't playing. So I'd like to just wrap up with my takeaway here. So there are two things which are very important. One is that it's important for us to preemptively work on important domains. So right now I would say that images and videos are not quite at the commercial level. But in the next 6 months to 1 year, they're going to be really good. So imagine applications to education, right? Where instead of reading a textbook, you could have the AI make a movie for the student. Imagine applications to entertainment, where you could have a TV show or movie made just for you. Imagine applications to media and advertisements and any form of content consumption, right? Humans are primarily visual creatures. So this is where this technology is going to have a huge impact. Secondly, it's on the data collection front. So we are making a huge effort to collect as much data as we can so that when the next breakthrough comes, we are able to leverage it as soon as possible. We don't want to waste time collecting data and building our expertise then. We are preparing all of that right now so that we can take advantage of the innovations as soon as they occur. So this is our website, bharatdiffusion.ai. You guys can go to this site or you can scan our QR code. Our model is going to release on 15 June. But if you go to our site and you join in the waitlist, let's say from now to the next 24 hours, we'll give you guys early access by the 10th of June. And I can't wait to see what you guys are creating. Thank you.